Who will bring his money when his general manager or his own will be abducted? So all those screaming for lack of jobs and so on, because we are not attracting capital investment, they should blame them for not cooperating with law enforcement agencies to get the criminals along among us, the abductors, you know, and the 419ers. They live with them, they know them. They can't accommodate them and then blame government for not building factories. The government cannot build all the factories required and employ all the people and produce all the goods and services. What the government should do is to provide security and convince entrepreneurs, both from abroad and from land, to invest, to employ people, to produce goods and services. And what the ordinary people and what Nigerians should do is expose the kidnappers and the thieves, you know.
So is it a confirmation that we are likely to see more of a General Buhari?
Well, I don't know what you make of me, but if you
are going to be more ruthless.
Well, all those who call me Baba go slow, they will see whether I'm slow or fast.
What does that mean, sir?
It means that I will persuade the police and the judiciary to be hard. And where I uncover that they are not hard, I will try and trace who is responsible for the slowness in terms of commanders or police from DPOs upwards. The IG alone cannot do everything. He has to depend on commissioners. The commissioners have to depend on DPOs.
One of your press singers, Larara from Kano, said, those who should run, should run. Is it a time, sir?
Well, it's up to them. If they stay, they know what will happen to them. The others didn't behave themselves, or they better run.
Okay, sir, what is your message to Nigerians as you start the last lap of your administration, and what do you expect from them?
My message to Nigerians is they should please expose the criminals in their neighborhood to help the government clear the country and attract foreign entrepreneurs to come and invest into the country, to create factories, you know, employ people and produce goods and services. This is what will move Nigeria forward. You cannot accommodate criminals in your neighborhood and start blaming government, glibly blaming government that nothing is being done. People are deliberately stopping government from doing anything.
You have been described differently by different people. Man of integrity, man of honor, incorruptible. Some simply say you are phenomenal in Nigeria's political landscape. How would you describe yourself personally? Who is Muhammadu Buhari?
Well, I like to start by praising teachers of my generation. I spent 9 years in boarding school, 3 years in primary boarding, and 6 secondary schools. Now I think they do 5 years or 4, I don't know how many years. The teachers then, they were treating children and students like their own children. If you do well as a student, they praise you in the classroom and in the assembly hall, which is held daily, 6 times a week. If you misbehave, you will be flogged in front of your class or in the whole assembly hall. So the best out of you is brought physically and academically. You have to be well to survive. You have to do well, be doing well to survive. I was a class monitor. I was a junior prefect. I was a senior prefect. I was a head boy. I earned all those, and I know what I went through. But without good teachers, I wouldn't have been able to do it.
So who is Muhammadu Buhari?
I think I went through hell throughout my career in the military. I was a lieutenant in Lagos during the first coup, 15th January 1966. And you If you bother about Nigerian history, you read coup, counter coup, civil war, coup, counter coup. I was all in it, including in detention for 3.25 years. So I'm fully qualified, you know, as a suffering Nigerian.
So, Your Excellency, Nigerians would like to know whether there's anything secret behind the remarkable way and manner people show you love, respect, and trust consistently since joining partisan politics in 2002 for free.
Well, I thank Nigerians for putting me under the microscope and seeing the way I came through. They knew I was a governor, now 6 states. I was in petroleum for 3.25 years. I was a military head of state. Then I joined partisan politics. When the uniform was removed from me, I tried 3 times, ending up in Supreme Court 3 times. And then I won 2015. And now constitutionally, I won the last time, the 5th time. So really, for somebody who has been in the field for 20 years, from bottom to top, I think if Nigerians show respect or love for me, I'm grateful they appreciated my efforts.
So there's not a secret about that?
There's no secret about it. The secret is that I try to survive. So all those who are trying to survive, they better continue trying harder. Eventually they will succeed. It's a question of trying harder and harder.
Finally, sir, recently you got some people confused when you visited Saudi Arabia.
Confused about what?
They saw you running.
Yes. Try and understand the performance of Hajj and Umrah. There is a certain place where we have to jog. That's all I was doing. I'm complying with the religious terms of doing the thing. And I'm begging God to lead me and make me succeed. And this is a place to do it. And I was doing it very hard.
They were wondering, how could the president be running like that?
Who is the president before God? He's just as ordinary as you. We are all ordinary before God.
Your Excellency, I'd like to say a very big thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you for making it very hard for me.
And to our TV viewing audience, thanks for your company. Join us next time, God's willing, for another special interview with President Muhammadu Buhari, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, Federal Republic of Nigeria. My name is Adamu Sambo saying, bye for now.